I was born November 23rd, 1963.
Here is a bulletin from CBS News. In Dallas, Texas, three shots were fired at President Kennedy's motorcade in downtown Dallas.
24 years ago, coming to this life, the son of a woman and a man who lived in strife, he was tired of being poor.
My mom heard the news of the assassination of John F. Kennedy and went into labor with me. I was born later that night.
And he worked like the devil to be more.
NBC's Bob McNeil on the line now with a report. Please go ahead. Died at approximately 1 o'clock Central Standard Time, which is about 35 minutes ago.
A different kind of poverty now upsets me so. Night after sleepless night, I walk the floor and I want to know, why am I so alone? Where is my woman? Can I bring her home? Have I driven her away? Is she gone? Morning comes to sunrise and I'm driven to my bed. I see that it is empty and there's devils in my head. I embrace many colored beasts. I grow weary of the torment. Can there be no peace? And I find myself just wishing that my life would simply cease.
From Dallas, Texas, the flash, apparently official, President Kennedy died at 1 p.m. Central Standard Time, 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, some 38 minutes ago.
Find the cost of freedom.
In November of 1969, my mom remarried. All of a sudden, I had a whole new family. I had a new dad who adopted me. Started a whole new life for me. It's a life I wouldn't trade for anything in the world.
Well, I came upon a child of God. He was walking along the road. And I asked him, tell me, where are you going? And this he told me.
60s were the age of youth, as 70 million children from the post-war baby boom became teenagers and young adults. The movement away from the conservative 50s continued and eventually resulted in revolutionary ways of thinking and real changes in the cultural fabric of American life. No longer content to be the images of the generation ahead of them, young people wanted change, and the changes affected education, values, lifestyles, laws, and entertainment. Many of the revolutionary ideas which began in the 60s are continuing to evolve today. Did growing up in this time influence me? Yeah, I think so. I've always considered myself somewhat of a hippie, I suppose. In the last 2 years of the 60s, we had barely gotten over the assassination of John F. Kennedy when his brother's life was tragically ended by an assassin's bullet. There were civil rights protests and another assassination of a man who just wanted us to know that all men were created as equals. We had a war overseas, flower power, hippies, color TV, a great big celebration of love and music on Max Yasgur's farm in upstate New York with Woodstock. We landed a man on the moon, drove muscle cars without thinking that gas would ever get much higher than 35 cents a gallon. We saw drug-crazed criminals paraded through the media as they went on their insane mission of murder and blamed it on the conformity of society. And we listened to the ravings of a lunatic claiming he was Jesus Christ. There was Timothy Leary and Jack Kerouac and all of their lunacy. And the Rolling Stones, The Who, Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, and of course the Beatles. I was 6 years old when I discovered music calling to me, and I picked up a guitar for the first time then and listened to Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band, my first album that I basically wore the grooves off of. I suppose that started it all. I was fascinated with music from that point on, and still listen to that album today, as a matter of fact. But my early influences, of course, were 60s groups. On through the 70s and 80s, I still listen to 60s groups. Thanks to my aunt and uncle's old record player and their old records. I suppose that started this whole thing a-rolling.
It's a long road that never turns. I never knew what the hell he was talking about. It's a long road that never turns. What does that mean? He always said it. And it's kind of funny because even as I got into my 20s, mid-20s, and was experiencing those interesting things that happen in life. Job stress, divorce, things of that nature. Problems seem to get a little bit bigger, seem to get more numerous and whatnot. Go to my dad and he'd always offer good advice. Sometimes I took it, sometimes I didn't. But he'd still always say, well, it's a long road that never turns. And I guess it was around then that I started really thinking about what he meant. I know what he meant. I learned what he meant when I was about 25, 26. It is a long road that never turns sometimes. You gotta keep going on it, you know. Try not to look back. I spend a lot of time looking back. I should be looking forward. But I wrote that song for him. It's a long road that never turns. I sat down and wrote it one night. The song basically wrote itself. A lot of the lyrics in it are things that he said or things that I interpreted. My interpretation of what he said. So that's where that song came from. He said, son, don't ever forget who you are. Show respect and be polite. Be slow to anger, and if you can't help it, be slow to criticize. Know when to forget and when to tell the truth. She said, then tell no lies. Do what you can. Between the lines, and don't you ever forget, never be left behind. A young man, the age of 28, the food got a little rougher. It may have been straight, but it was all uphill, and I got a little tougher. And I flew past those warning signs and rode with Lady Luck. Soon I found that you can't circle round looking for shortcuts. Cause that road you think's a shortcut is a road with many turns. And a wise man always learns. Just watch the signs, don't cross the lines. Don't ever drive it blind, cause you never know where it might go. Sometimes you can't get back what you left behind.
Turns out that long road that never turns sometimes has some hills and valleys in it. Things happen that you never thought would happen. I had a lot of things happen to me that weren't so good. A lot of things happened to me that were good. But in 2004, I ended up in Las Vegas, Nevada, playing with Phil Collins' Genesis tribute show. And I really enjoyed that. You know, they say when you play Vegas, you've done something. Well, I've played Vegas, continue to play Vegas. I ended up moving here, falling in love. Not with Vegas, but with a beautiful lady. And although I'm not with the Phil Collins Genesis tribute band, I still play. But even still, I haven't done what it is that I want to do. I haven't achieved what I want to achieve. You know, I've stayed in really nice hotel suites here in Vegas and had some really cool experiences playing music here. It still wasn't, it still isn't the bee's knees that I thought it would be. This is one of those first shows with Inside Out. Actually, I didn't even really know the songs. I was just kind of following my way through them. So it was a little nerve-wracking at first. Of course, it became old hat after a while. Once again, I found myself playing behind somebody else. And, you know, I've always played guitar and enjoyed that. Always enjoyed being the lead guitarist, but I've always wanted to sing and front my own band. So I was enjoying playing with this band, but growing a little weary of working for somebody else. Studio in my home. It's my own home studio. It's where I do most of my songwriting, my recording. Late at night when everybody else goes to bed, I'm usually up burning the midnight oil, so to speak. That's what I'm doing right now, as a matter of fact. This is a tune that I didn't write, actually. It's a song written by one of the most incredible talents that I've ever run across in my life, a gentleman by the name of Bam Bam Morgan, incredible drummer, a very creative soul, a very creative person, probably one of my best friends in the world. He's toured the world with Jody Watley, Andre Simone. As I said, just an incredible talent. He'll basically write these intricate drum parts and add keyboards to them. And he lives in Minnesota, so what he'll do is he'll email me the files, and I'll import them into my home studio. I'll add the guitar tracks to them and send them back to him. It's fun. We enjoy riding together from a long distance. Bam Bam's music challenges me. He writes these incredibly intricate songs that pushes me play beyond my comfort level, and I appreciate that. One of the best drummers I've ever worked with, and fortunately I'm still able to work with him even though we live, you know, 1,000 miles away from each other. You know, on the songs that I record, I've just found that it's easier for me to play all the instruments myself. I enjoy playing drums. Been doing that for a while. For as many years as I've been playing guitar and drums, I've recently picked up the piano, and I find it easier to write on the piano. I really enjoy playing the piano. It's kind of new for me, and I'm teaching myself as I go. It's a relaxing type thing for me. I really like it. Most often I'll have lyrics already written about something that's affected me or something that I'm going through, and I'll take the lyrics, and if it sounds like it's a song that lends itself to piano, I'll just sit down at the piano as I'm doing here and start just playing whatever comes off the top of my head until I feel something that seems to fit with the lyrics, kind of like what I'm doing right here.
Shatter, and it's easier to break. My weary heart rises up on wings.
born here in the land of cotton. You were born on a rainy day. Since then, sweet things long forgotten, they just keep flooding back my way. Oh, child, I cannot tell you how the time just flies. But I have had my days of glory under sunny skies. Dreams are all I want to see. So sleep tight, Annabelle. You can always count on me. In this cold world, folks will judge you, though they don't know you at all. And I may not be there to catch you anytime that you might fall. But you've got my hard head and your mother's grace. All the likeness of loved ones right there in your face. And I know in the end you'll be who you will be. I think the whenever I see stuff like this, I guess the artist in me comes out, because I always want to try to write something, write a song. It's not always easy to put something like this into words, which is why sometimes instead of writing words to my songs, I'll leave them as instrumentals. Can't put words to something like that. How do you describe that? You know, you can use corny adjectives, beautiful, you know, breathtaking. Sometimes just the emotional part of the music can describe it best.
Thank you.
leaving Las Vegas. Leaving Las Vegas on a trip to Sedona, Arizona, and Flagstaff and Grand Canyon. Our weekend road trip. Who knows what's going to happen? I guess I should watch the road, huh?
I would prefer that, please.
Party at the wheel! On out of this town. Southern Railroad in a little town I grew up in called Ashdown, Arkansas. Little town. My house was just on the outskirts of town. It still is, where my folks live. And there's a train crossing about a quarter of a mile from our house. And when you'd hear the train come through, you know, you'd hear the distant, kind of the rumble, you know, you can hear it coming. Because it usually had, you know, 3 to 4 freight engines, so it was pretty loud. And as it approached the crossing, of course, it started blowing the whistle. That sound from my childhood still remains in the back of my head to this day. And it's a comforting sound, actually. You know, when I was a kid, I never thought much about it. I was, you know, laying in bed at night, usually around the same time every night it came through. Just a sound that I'll never forget. The sound of the whistle, you know, in the distance. And getting closer, you start hearing the rumble of the engines. Getting closer, starts blowing the horn, you know, blows the horn all the way up to the crossing. And then you know when it's past the crossing because you hear the Doppler effect of the horn, you know, go by. And just a comforting sound. I'll never forget that. Never thought about it as a kid, but boy, I sure would like to hear that.
We'll be right back.
have passed since you and I first met. Thinking about the times we've spent, good times I'll never forget. All those times we laughed and cried, no time to spend apart.